Do any of these sort of come as a surprise to you, right? I would assume not. Or is this consistent to what you've been hearing in the industry?
Yeah, so I would say it's not a surprise. This is consistent, and even in a pre-COVID era, these three areas were key. And a lot of it comes back to a very common retail metric, which is OTIF, coined by Walmart years ago, which is on time in full, right? And you think about like what are the leading and enablement indicators to OTIF? It's making sure I've got the right product, making sure that my suppliers understand my delivery date, and then understanding the logistics realm of it, of carrier performance. And so, those are just several examples. So overall, not surprised. When I think of our retail customers and the engagement we've had from our own customers, but also others in the market over the last year, is that we have seen huge fluctuations in volume, right? And so this bullwhip effect that we've talked a lot about over the last year was real. And then as supply chains course correct, it does cause these bottlenecks. And what we see is just both on the supplier side and the retailer side is how do I get through these bottlenecks with as minimal impact and disruption to my business? And so these are things that when we look at our customer base, whether it's Best Buy that's also talking on the panel, or folks like PetSmart in the retail space, they've been able to leverage Forkites to help understand that visibility. So when the pandemic happened or other disruptions, it's minimized because they've got the true order level visibility, but also the customer level visibility that's needed to run their supply chain.
Absolutely. I mean, visibility is so important, especially right now.